Here's the problem. It's life insurance that only pays off when we die, because the threat to our family's financial security is not limited to our death. In fact, due to advancements in medical technology, many more of us are surviving an illness or an injury, like a heart attack or cancer or an automobile accident, that in the past would have resulted in our death. And surviving an accident or critical illness now creates new threats to our financial security, like major expenses that our health insurance doesn't cover, including deductibles and co-payments, or fees and charges for physicians, clinics, or treatment centers that are not within our healthcare network, or unconventional therapies, or experimental procedures not yet approved by the FDA, or extensive convalescence, or home nursing care, or assistance with housekeeping, cooking, and childcare, or the loss of our monthly income while we recuperate from surgery, or struggle through chemotherapy and radiation treatments. These uncovered expenses are quite common and can cost us tens of thousands of dollars, often over several months or even years of treatment and recovery. That's why 48% of all home foreclosures and 17% of all personal bankruptcies are directly attributable to a long-term disability, illness, or injury. So where can we get the money to pay for these expenses? With a new type of life insurance, known as living benefits life insurance. Because this new type of life insurance allows us to take a cash advance against the tax-free death benefit while we are still living. Of course, ordinary life insurance will pay a tax-free death benefit to your family, which they can use to pay off the mortgage and replace your income. But with living benefits life insurance, a portion of that death benefit can also be advanced to you before you die. Eligible conditions for a cash advance will vary by coverage provisions, but typically include the diagnosis of a critical condition, such as invasive or malignant cancer, heart attack or stroke, kidney or liver failure, blindness or paralysis, or the need for life support or an organ transplant, or the inability to perform normal daily living activities, such as bathing, dressing, or feeding oneself, or a terminal illness with less than 24 months to live, and permanent confinement to a nursing home or hospice care facility. What's more, when you need money to pay for college or weddings or your own retirement, you can also take out low-interest tax-free loans secured by the equity or cash value of your insurance. And these loans will be automatically paid off with the tax-free death benefit when the contract terminates at the end of your life, essentially advancing you a portion of the death benefit while you are still living. That's why it's called living benefits life insurance. Of course, whatever you take out while you are alive will reduce the death benefit left to your family. But with living benefits life insurance, you can now stop thinking of life insurance as death insurance. You can now start thinking of life insurance as a tax-exempt financial security asset, an asset that can provide you with a lifetime of tax-free benefits, so that the money you pay into your life insurance is no longer a budgetary expense, but is now a budgetary investment, contractually guaranteed to provide you with a lifetime of tax-exempt financial security.